those leaders who taught us and led us with examples while they are in our midst. God placed them in our midst in order to guide us and to learn from them.
On behalf of the chairperson, Professor Lazarus Haruna, who unfortunately could not be with us this afternoon, and on behalf of the team which compiled the book which will be launched today, let me welcome you to this great event.
When I was going through the leadership theories, I realized that the leadership theories that are present today, which are the great men theory, trait theory, behavioral theory, contingency theory, all these theories have a Western origin. But I rather find African theories that speaks about our great leaders. I must start saying that Africa is a great continent, and we are cut from greatness. And when I started pondering for many years, I pondered about His Excellency Dr. Sammy Yoma's leadership. How does he do it? How does he get it right to be so consistent? And as I was one day going through his accolades, honors and recognition, 32 titles, 15 honorary doctorates, I realized that this great son of the soil, not only for Namibia, but for Africa, have great leadership capabilities that we need to learn from. And therefore, as my professor has said, I decided to assemble a team that have worked closely and have credentials to understand His Excellency Dr. Sammy Yoma's leadership. The reason why I believe that we can still learn from him, otherwise, in this world of leadership, the Harvard Business Leadership University of Stellenbosch should not have leadership schools, because we all believe that we can learn from leadership and we can refine our leadership. What more about this great African son of Africa? And I thought of as a memorial for his 90th birthday, this great team worked tirelessly around the clock to produce a book. And I thought that this book will be a very good tool for the coming generation to learn from. There is no perfection in leadership, but there is consistency and character. And today we are paying tribute to His Excellency Dr. Sammy Yoma by looking at this book, and Prof. Mshigeli is going to talk about it. But we have interviewed a lot of people, and what we have quickly realized is that everyone was very consistent about His Excellency. And we are here today to learn about that. And I hope that the journey that we have worked, I hope that you will start your own journey so that we can make Africa a great continent with great leaders and Africa a better place. Directors of Ceremony, I thank you.
Thank you very much, Julia. Ladies and gentlemen, the book we are launching today, or this afternoon, we're going to get a synopsis of that now, and it's our distinct honor to introduce Professor Mshigeli, who is going to give us that synopsis. Ladies and gentlemen, please, let's give him a good round.
You know what the elders do? They go and sit down and tell us stories. Let me do that. Director of Ceremonies, Mr. Lazarus Jacobs, Right Honorable Prime Minister, Professor Kukungelwa Amadila, representing His Excellency Dr. Habib Benko, President of the Department of Namibia, Your Excellency Dr. Sam Yoma, founding President of Namibia and founding Chancellor of the University of Namibia, the Honorable Minister, Chapter 3, strategic decision making and execution. The chapter starts with a professional analysis of strategic decision making and execution of such processes. It then analyzes the unique attributes characterizing the human group. The chapter systematically and artistically presents a seven-step model which His Excellency Dr. Nyoma adheres towards the timely execution of his strategic goals. The chapter portrays him as a leader endowed with sharp analytical skills, clarity of vision towards identifying short-term and longer-term development goals, and presents well-researched factual examples which reveal that Nyoma is an exemplary leader who understands the merits of delegation of authority and who does a close follow-up on the implementation of those delegated duties, which results in great successes in all his undertakings.
Comrade Shafi Shuna Nyoma is no ordinary human being, for he has walked a path only few can ever walk. He hails from a group of continental luminaries who had the courage, conviction, and determination to unite their people and thereby launch a successful struggle against colonial oppression. These were the first wave of African leaders who possessed the leadership qualities fit to initiate revolutions. It is therefore fitting that today we are launching a book on Comrade Nyoma, which speaks to one of his most outstanding qualities, his leadership. A large majority of us present here today have in one way or the other benefited from the leadership of Comrade Shafi Nyoma. He epitomizes the principles of true leadership, and therefore it is apt that such invaluable gifts and talents are documented in order to inform current and future generations of Namibians about the qualities of our distinguished leader.
Under the able leadership of Professor Russell Samura, has done a great job, and I wish to congratulate him most sincerely. I do not know if you have deserved all the praises and accolades written about me in the book. As all I did was to follow the discipline, the tenacity, and the cultural values and the norms instilled in me by my parents as the firstborn child in the family. Nevertheless, it is my wish that lessons that I have learned throughout my life journey that have been identified in the book will be beneficial to many generations to come.
Dr. Bob, just to place that. Yes, I am. Thank you. Our first minister, also Bob. Thank you so much. Going once. Dr. Ekete, nominee, Dr. Ekete, two boxes. You can't come all the way home when Diva just won. Okay, Dr. Ekete, thank you so much. Thank you, Robert, that's a box. Who else? I assume everybody else would buy a book. We'll close the doors. You cannot leave without a book. Yes, the books he has. Thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Can I please ask all of us to rise for the singing of the AU and then the nation?
The first medical doctor we trained in the Soviet Union, in the Russian Federation. These are acoustic equipment that was addressing the equipment of the Defense Force in Havana.
So I'm very happy and proud that the old Lazarus invited me in the hill. Sacred honor. For starting this time. The day before yesterday, and today, being with you. It's a great, great inspiration.
We are happy to see you.